Hello, welcome to next session. In this session, we will solve some questions of industrial engineering. The topic is sequencing. Question number 1 to 5 carries a common statement. The statement is 8 jobs 1 to 8 are to be processed on a single machine. The processing time and due time for the jobs are represented in the table. So job, these are the job 1 to 8, okay, and this is the processing time for this job, and this is the due time for this job. So processing time is 5, 8, 6, 3, 10, 14, 7 and 3 for 8 jobs respectively, and due time is 15, 10, 15, 25, 20, 40 and 40, 45 and 50 for these 8 jobs. Assume that no new job arrive thereafter. Using shortest processing time rule, question number 1, mean flow time is option A 23.875 minutes, option B 32 minutes, option C 28 minutes, option D 26 minutes. Question number 2 is average in processing time is, or you can say cardinality is, option A 3.41 job, option B 4.757 job, option C 3.91 job, option D 4.86 job. Question number 3, mean lateness is option A -3.625 minutes, option B 22 minutes, option C 9 minutes, option D 4.5 minutes. Question number 4, maximum lateness is option A 22 minutes, option B 9 minutes, option C 8 minutes and option D 12 minutes. Question number 5, number of jobs actually late are option A 3, option B 4, option C 5 and option D 2. So here this is the table given, and we have to arrange the jobs according to shortest processing time. The shortest processing time is for out of this job is for two jobs, that is for 4 and for 8, and for both the processing time is 3. So we'll arrange them we'll take them first and second. Okay. So this is your the sequence is 4 to 4 and 8 or 8 or 4. Okay, next higher time is for after 3, the next higher time is 5, and that is for 1. Okay. And so next job to process is 1. And next higher time is for 3, that is 6. Okay, so next job to process is 3. And next higher time is for 7, or that is 7. Okay, so the next job is 7. Next higher time is for 2, that is 8. So next job to process is 2. Next higher time is for 5, that is 10. So the next job to be 5. Next higher time is for 6, that is 14, so it will be processed last. Okay. So now we have the sequence according to shortest processing time. And now for this fourth job, the processing time is 3. Okay. So its completion time is 3, because it is started. It is the first job to be processed. Okay. So, and now for the job 8, the processing time is 3, and it will be completed, and it will be processed after 4, so its completion time is 3 plus 3 is 6. Similarly, for 1, the processing time is 5, so its completion time is 6 plus 5 is 11. And for 3, next 3, the processing time is 6. First completion time is 11 plus 6, 17. And for 7, the processing time is 7. So its completion time is 24. And for 2, the processing time is 8. So its completion time is 24 plus 8, 32. And for 5, the processing time is 10. So its completion time is 32 plus 10, 42. And for 6, processing time is 14, so its completion time is 42 plus 14, that is 56 respectively. Okay. So these are the completion times, and this is the shortest processing time sequence. Okay. So now from this completion time, if we add this completion time, so that is 3 plus 6 plus 11 plus 24 plus 32 plus 42 plus 56, okay, and divide by number of jobs, then we get mean flow time. So that is, that comes out as 23.875. So answer to question number 1 is A. Okay. Next is average in processing density. So when job 4 is being processed, so 8 jobs are in process, okay, or 8 jobs are in inventory. Okay. So as the processing time for job 4 is 3, so 0 to 3 there are 8 jobs in inventory. Okay. And similarly for the when job 8 is being processed, 7 jobs are in inventory, and when this 1 is in process, so 6 are in inventory. Okay. And when 3 is in process, so 4 are in inventory, and when this 7 is in process, then 4, and when 2 is in process, then 3, and when 5 is in process, then 2, and when 6 is in process, there is 1 job in inventory. Okay. So now we have this this data, as its processing time is 0 to 3, and it's 0 to 3 to 6, okay, and it's 6 to 11, okay, because this is the starting time, and there is the finishing time of 4 jobs, and then 4, 8, 2, 3, and 6. So likewise, we are writing the time in minutes according to this thing, okay. So now, when 8 jobs are in process, then the 8 jobs are in process for time 3 minutes, and 7 jobs are in process for time 3 minutes, 6 jobs are in process for time 5 minutes, and 5 jobs are in process for 6 minutes, 4 jobs are in process for 7 minutes, 3 jobs are in process for 8 minutes, 2 jobs are in process for 10 minutes, and 1 job in process inventory for 14 minutes. Okay. Now we'll find out the total time or total time for 8 jobs in process, okay, or the total processing time. Okay. So that is the total processing time, and if we divide it by the total time for the completion of jobs, then it will be average in processing inventory, that is 191 by 6, that is 3.41 jobs. It means the 3.41 jobs are in average in process during the manufacturing. Okay. So, so average in process inventory is 3.41 jobs. So answer is A. Okay. So next is lateness. So when as the due date for job 4 is 25 and its processing time is 3, so its lateness is minus 22. And similarly for job 8, the completion time is 6, and due date is 50, so it is its lateness is minus 22. And similarly for 1, lateness is due date is 15. Latest is minus 4, and similarly for 3 it is 2, and for 7 it is minus 21 according to due date, okay, and for 2 it is 22, and for 5 it is 22, and for 6 it is 16. So mean lateness can be found out by summing these and dividing by number of jobs. So mean lateness is minus 3.625 minutes, and maximum lateness is out of these is 22, and number of jobs actually are 1, 2, 3, and 4. So answer is B, yes, A,